like to think that Hu is not about me, because if the book was only about me, it would have lasted maybe 3 pages and we'll be done with me. I like to believe that I talked about the life of many boat people, maybe not most of them, but some of the boat people who arrived here at the same time or under the same circumstances than my family. Because we were very lucky. We were in a camp for a very short period. We were there only for 4 months. And our boat trip lasted also only for 4 days, whereas other many boats lasted for weeks, and they had to go through running out of water, running out of food, whereas we were still fine after 4 days. And we arrived in Malaysia with no major problems, major events, I would say. There was no raping, no stealing. So we were very lucky. And but most of the boat people who tried to cross the ocean didn't have the same luck. We didn't know much about Quebec. No, we didn't know at all about Quebec. We knew a little bit about Canada. And the most stunning image, I would say, was we arrived at the airport and there was snow everywhere around us. It was totally white. And when you think about it, I was born in a country at war, and then after that we lived a couple of years in a country in chaos, in transition, and then we moved to a refugee camp where the color is basically dirt. We had not seen the color white for so long, and to me it was just so pure. Even today I would say that every first snowfall, I would feel like there's something renewed, or being renewed, or a rebirth. And to me, that moment was my second birth, arriving in Canada, and to see that purity and virginity almost. So I never thought that Hu would be read by anybody except me, and not even my family, because they know the story. They've lived through the same period. And certainly not the Vietnamese, because they also had the same story. And so I thought maybe some of my friends, for being kind. So I never thought that Hu could find itself in so many different countries today. And I had a chance to go to meet with these readers from abroad. And it's every single time, it's so amazing, because they each country would read Hu from a different angle. For example, Romania, they really talked about the communist page, the same history page that we had in common. And I remember one journalist saying that he remembers very well how his mother heated tea on top of a candle, because they didn't have any electricity. It was really cold. They had to go around the house in a winter coat, but then they had this teapot just on top of a candle. And in Vietnam, we made coffee out of burned bread or burned rice. So there were so many similarities, and that was Romania. And in France, it was totally something else. It was about the structure of the text and how it was being written. So it's such a blessing. I don't know how come this book could be read by so many different readers and in so many different ways. I think Hu basically is a book with keywords. I just say apple, and then each reader would see a different apple, and they think that I had drawn that apple for them. But I think it's really the reader who has given the third dimension to the book.